hearing docket is for a Mr. Jacob Brown.
1235. Brown is not present. I would formally object since he's had more than enough time to make arrangements to have his attorney here or have an attorney here or do something else. But this is a matter of the board for decision and notification to Mr. Brown. And let me say this, if you want to postpone it, I would like to make a recommendation to the board that we take some action with regard to this business because of the number of complaints as well as the severity of the complaints pending before this board for which we were to make a decision today. So that's a separate request, but I want to attach it to the motion or the request to postpone.
And then we probably should have you did read, depending on what action the board takes today, we should probably have you sworn in and have you reread the text message about them, you know, and have that also help the official.
So I'm just going to test one, give this here to the truth.
I do. This is the email sent from Jacob Brown to me and to the board yesterday, and I believe the time is 10:05. Anna, I was waiting to hear back from my attorney after I spoke with you on Thursday or Friday. At that time, I thought that the board meetings were being held on Tuesdays for some reason. So whenever I finally got in touch with him to see if Monday was okay, he informed me that he had to be in court on Monday. Then on top of that, I also got a cancer call from my doctor's office saying that I'm scheduled to get some blood work done tomorrow morning. I'm extremely sorry for the late notice. I really didn't think that it would be a problem for him to switch the date to Monday. I can have him draft up a document stating that he already had another court date scheduled. I know I'll get something sent to my doctor's office saying that I already had an appointment. Please let me know if these items will be necessary.
The following statement, that he was on our board for couple years now, at least, so I'm not exact date, but he knew that our meetings were on Mondays, so the Tuesday excuse to me is not acceptable to my vote. Now, whether or not his attorney can't make it, couldn't make it, or he had blood work, that I can't dispute that. However, if we choose to go ahead and follow procedures today or postpone it, I do think that's up for a vote for you guys. I personally would like to see it go and be finished today. He had ample enough time to show up. To me, this should trump anything else that may have come up, but that's just my opinion.
Being an auctioneer and an attorney, and I realize that lawyers can't commit to a client within a day or two if they have a schedule that they have to follow, and also if we had blood tests, this might be a reason to postpone it, maybe to the next meeting. With regard to the Tuesday meetings, even though we were supposed to have meetings on Monday, they will continue to Tuesday at the request of a previous chairman. So, that part of it's true, and they've only been held on a Monday for a year, I believe. Well, it hasn't been 3 years since Jacob's been president. I mean, it's a very serious thing involving himself and his business. And I think, to handle something like this in absentia, which means without him, I have
great
doubts about it.
Anna, what is your stance? What do we do about his license? We can't really operate under these conditions. He's got to be stopped.
What I've learned now, I have provided you the only defense that he's provided to me today, which is on the 4th complaint, which says, and he did put in the record that he had received notice that the party had been paid. We checked with the party, they're saying that they don't know why that is available to them, but they're not showing it was ever paid, which is a large amount of money. Pattern here is that I've not heard from an attorney. This has been going on, to be honest with you. I sent copies of the documents and requested a response last fall for everything that happened prior last fall. We have auctions which occurred in February and I believe May of 2017 that we're dealing with here that he has not made good. Setting aside the one defense, I don't know that there was any. He has also informed me in writing that he's down to one employee and that it is difficult for him to keep up with his particular case. And that, as a result, I'm concerned about the well-being of the business itself. And allowing him to continue if he is. I don't know that we have an upcoming auction. I did not check if you would do that for me in the near future. I know he's continuing to operate from the location in Munis, Louisiana. And I'm concerned if he cannot pay his consigners, which seems to be part of the problem, nor can they title to vehicles that he is selling, that I don't know the board doesn't need to make some sort of arrangement to also suspend his license pending this hearing. I have not made a formal motion.
Okay, can the license be suspended pending a hearing, say, on May the 8th?
Yes, I believe our next meeting is May 7th.
May 7th?
Yeah, and I'll put it on Tuesday.
And tell him that it's mandatory that he be there, him and his attorney. That certainly is adequate notice. I mean, I'm just throwing that out. At least it would give him a chance to be heard, because the consequences of the violation could be extremely serious and definitely will reflect on him and the business.
What's the total amount of money we're talking about? I don't think it looks like it's a sizable amount.
The Transcan complaint is, how much total is that, Raj?
The Transcan is $15,821, I believe. There are some other smaller issues, and there is one that has not come before our board yet.
We do have another one that we're aware of that's been important to come
I'll make the motion using the cease and desist order pending the hearing date of tomorrow of May
7th. And I would second that.
I mean, cease and desist completely. If he's got a business license and suspended at his personal office.
It's just his individual. He's not the only auctioneer affiliated with that company.
Spend his license number 1441 until the hearing date of May 7th.
I would second that.
All those in favor?
Aye.
And roll call it.
Roll call it.
Roll call it. Mr. Lockett?
Yes.
Yes.
Mr. Henderson?
Yes.
Motion passes.
As we're going to close out the hearing, the matter is going to be continued to May the 7th, 2018, at what time?
Let's say 12 noon.
12 noon. All right, and you will make sure that he is sent out the notice?
I'll make sure. I'll also should you as hearing officer sign off the cease and desist as the part of the hearing? I'll prepare one for signature.
Yes, I can, because that's part of what the board has ordered. That it will be a board order, so I would need the chairman of the